us, because he was he is very ill right now, and inshallah may Allah give him shifa. And alhamdulillah, we thank Allah first of all, and then we thank our Sheikh Abdul Masin Ahmed, who didn't hesitate at all to replace the Sheikh and send for the Sharaf of the talk in very, very short notice. So jazakallahu khairan, wa barakallahu fi, and I will leave you inshallah with the Sheikh.
جزاك الله خير. هل نعلقه يمشي خلاص؟ جزاك الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف خلق الله أجمعين، نبينا محمد عليه وعلى آله وصحابته أفضل الصلاة وتأم التسليم. أما بعد، I believe you need to test your patience. This is the moment. You need to test your patience and tolerance. That the advertisement or the announcement was about someone, and all of a sudden you found someone else. But I think we all have peers, right? طيب, you have 5 minutes if you want to decide to go out. After 5 minutes, doors will be locked. أسأل الله الإعانة والتوفيق. Actually, it is my pleasure to have a step forward toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is our task in this life. This is the primary duty that all of us have on this earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا, that I haven't created human beings and jinn except for one main reason. Yes, we have universities, we have different tasks here and there towards our family, our kids, our friends, our beloved ones. Yes, but there is the main priority, the main reason of our existence is إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, for them to worship me alone. Looking at people, no, looking at ourselves, are we really doing what we're supposed to do? I won't expect any answers from anyone, but just each of us must ask and answer him and herself. Just spend 10 minutes alone. Are you really fulfilling the purpose of your existence? إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Just think about your timetable, your daily schedule. How much of it is purely for the Almighty God subhanahu wa ta'ala? How much? When you do any action, any deed, anything, even if when you're studying, when you're doing literature review, or teaching someone, or going to shop, what is in your mind? Someone would say, studying does not have anything to do with my ibadah. صح? Two people, A and B, both spend the same amount of time studying. One, while he or she studies, thinking, how can I benefit Islam and humanity and be rewarded from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the knowledge I learn every day? After 1 hour, this person has gained a lot of reward, hasanat. He cannot see it. You cannot see it. Visually, you cannot see it. But you can see it with your heart if you have a strong belief. Our main problem that we get used to see what we can see. We believe on what we can see. What is the main difference between human beings and other creatures, other animals and everything? What is the main reason or the main difference?
Mind.
Do you think animals don't have minds? Do you think that they don't think?
Yeah.
they think. صح؟ If a cat sees you, she won't come to you because she thinks. She is thinking that she might be harmed by getting close to you. صح؟ But a wolf won't care. A lion won't care. صح؟ Because they know that they are either stronger or weaker. صح؟ This is why sometimes we try to deceive animals to catch them. You cannot catch any, you can't just go to the pigeon and just catch it. You cannot. صح؟ So it is not, it's not العقل. It's not the thinking process. They think. And monkeys are very clever. Rats, you cannot just call a rat, come, I'll give you something. You cannot. صح؟ So what is it? The main difference. It is the belief of the unseen. You can't convince a human being that if you do this, I will reward you in a year time. I'll give you a salary in 1 month time. They don't see the money. They don't touch it. صح؟ Yet they believe that it is there. But I cannot tell a dog, if you're good, after 1 month, I'll give you a salary. This is why when they reward dogs, they reward them instantaneously. صح؟ Immediately. When he does something good, they will give him a reward immediately. You cannot convince animals of heaven or angels, the existence of angels. Can you? Can you? You can't. I will concentrate, inshallah, in this talk about one main issue. It is the trust between us and the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is it existed? I believe the main issue, the main problem that most humans have is the trust with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you recite the Quran with your heart, anybody can share with us what is the main purpose? I'm just repeating the word main. Main purpose of life, main purpose of our existence is al-ibadah. Main difference between us and other creature. And what is the main purpose of having the Quran between our hands? What is it? Great. That is if we follow the commands in the Holy Quran properly, to apply it. Good. There is something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has stated very clearly. To remind ourselves. But again, there is
Sakina.
This is another beneficial aspect. But what is the main? Only one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran one main purpose from sending the Quran down to us. Hudan wa rahma. True. Guidance. It is guidance. But for us, what does it mean? What do we need to do? True. That is true. Do you want me to recite the verse? And then we'll try just to extract. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, كتاب, it is a book. أنزلناه إليك مبارك, a book that we have sent down to thee, full of blessings, مبارك. Why لي? This, when you see this war, this letter in Arabic language, لي, this letter will give you the rationale why I came here لي ألقي محاضرة. To give the lecture. So, lam al-ta'lil. This lam, li, will give you the justification why the previous statement has happened. Okay? So I came here to give this two is means li u'ti al-muhadara. Okay? So what is after li? ليدبروا آياته. سبحان الله. He didn't say لي, then he سبحانه وتعالى gives millions of points. It is only one main point. كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياتي, for them to meditate on its signs, to stop with this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is amazing, wallahi amazing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say ليدبروا صوره, then they will just concentrate and meditate on the chapters. No, آياته, each ayah is a miracle by its own. Each ayah, each verse is a miracle by its own. ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب. طيب. So the main purpose of having the Quran with us is ليدبروا, تدبر. Okay, تدبر. Does that verse convince us that it is the main purpose? It is the main purpose. ليدبروا. Someone would ask and think systematically, what does ليدبروا mean? Because I need to know what it is in order to apply it. Otherwise, there is no point in knowing what is the main purpose without knowing how to achieve it. ليدبروا. What is a دبر? Meditation.
Reflection.
Reflection.
Contemplation.
Think deeply. That all of them are true. What organ do I need to have in order to achieve this contemplation?
Clean heart.
A heart? Can I do it with my eyes?
Yeah.
No. Even if you have a falcon sight. So it is that with the heart. How did you know it is by the heart? How did you know? Every single thing you need is mentioned in the Holy Quran and in the Sunnah. Every single thing. Do I have an evidence? The main distinguishing factor of this Ummah is the Dalil, the evidence. Because we have 10,000 of people around Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ruhi lahu al-fida, just watching him, what he was doing, how he sleeps on the right side, how every single thing has been revealed to us. We are Ummah of Dalil, Ummah of evidence. We have been taught with what leg and what foot to enter the toilet, صح? And what foot to get into the masjid. Can you see such a details, such standards in any religion? And subhanAllah, by the way, just Muslim must think of any action he does or she does. Any action, because it has a meaning. Whether you know it or you don't know it, it has a meaning. When Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam taught us with what foot or leg to enter the toilet, which one, right or left?
Left.
Left, صح. And to get from the toilet to the dunya,
right.
And to get from the dunya to the masjid,
right.
To the right. If you want to go from the masjid to the dunya,
left.
With the left, so you're going down. So even when you're stepping to the masjid, your heart must be awake and say, okay, you're now getting to the place. If you go to the office of the manager, your feeling must be different than when you go to the office of the security. Something that you don't control. صح? So what if you're going to the Baytullah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Anyway, going back to why every single thing that you need has been detailed in the Holy Quran. وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ What does كُلَّ شَيْءٍ mean? Everything. Every single thing, every single thing. وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ What? فَصَّلْنَاهُ Has been detailed. Extensive details. فَصَّلْنَاهُ تَفْصِيلًا Everything has been discussed and mentioned in the source that we have. So we should be proud of this. So back among this tafsil, among this details, how do we know that tadabbur is by heart? Is that the question? We stopped that? So we knew that the Quran has been sent down to us to make tadabbur. So we need to know what organ do I need to have this tadabbur with me. We said the heart. But Sheikh, we're waiting for him to get us the dalil from the Quran. Wallahi innik garabt. You're very close there. But just it is the word even tadabbur. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Do you have rewards, Sheikh? Where is the water, Sheikh? Lala, because he brought me a water. I asked for water. Actually, I asked him, I said, do you usually have a good hospitality with your lecturer? He said, yes. I said, where is the water? Then he brought me a cold one, which I cannot tolerate. So I will give you this, a gift.
It's from me to you.
Zakallah khair. So I will give it to him because he wants to put to give me in trouble and damage my throat. طيب Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ Subhanallah. What does that mean? Don't they whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means with they? Us. It is me. When I read this verse, it is me. Usually Satan, the devil, will make you think of everybody else except yourself. When you hear any verse or read any verse, the Satan is there. He will just make you think of everybody except yourself. So we, in order to make the tadabbur, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said they, meaning you, then you need to be awake. You need to have full attention to this verse. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ Don't they contemplate, meditate? الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ Allahu Akbar. Don't they contemplate on the Holy Quran? Or, am, or what? We have only two options. No third option. It's whether or. Whether you meditate in the Holy Quran, you really feel it. You really feel what you are reading. It is discussing, it is talking to you. Only you. Do we feel that when we hear, listen to the Quran, or read the Quran, recite the Quran, or memorize the Quran? It's never too late, but we need to start. أَفَلَا يَتَدَّبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ Or what? أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا Or their hearts have been locked up. So what does it mean if my heart is locked up? That means you won't benefit from the Quran even if you memorize the 30 chapters in your mind, because it is not the place of tadabbur. Even if you just keep, since the hour or the minute you wake up until the minute you sleep, you're just staring at the Holy Quran with these eyes. The upper part means nothing. Literally means nothing if your heart is not in the equation, or it's not open. If you have the equation and the heart is missing, That means tadabbur is zero. We have patients in our hospitals. May Allah cure them all. They have something called NG tube, nasogastric tube, a tube that is inserted from the nose to the stomach in order to feed them because they cannot have oral feeding. So if you give them salty water and you ask them, what is the taste? What would they say? We don't know. صح? If you give them honey, the purest, okay. So now the lecture will be inshallah better. Jazakallah khair. Sheikh, it's cold, ya habibi. Jazakallah khair. Allah yajzak khair, Sheikh, ويرزقك تدبر. لحالك جميع إن شاء الله. So if you ask them about the honey, the most pure and sweetie honey, by just giving it to through the NG tube, what does it taste? Nil. I don't know. صح? Has no taste. Why? Because it bypasses the place which, sorry, I'll just taste the water inshallah. ما تنفتح يا شيخ محمد ذي والله ما ادري عنك. Can you stop the stop. طيب بسم الله. JazakAllah khair, alhamdulillah. So because the tongue is bypassed and is out of the equation, you cannot know what is the taste. صح? The Quran is tasted by heart. If this is not in the equation, then you will read, yes, but you don't know what is it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran that if you have a tadabbur, لِيَتَدَبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ وَلِيَتَذَكَّرُوا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ, that you will feel it in your heart first. Then it will change something in your mind. It will change your practice. It will change something that you love, but you will leave it for something better. You will go towards something that you may hate to have something better. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, the schema of the Holy Quran, the schema of what you need to do. نزل به الروح الأمين. Jibreel has carried the Holy Quran from the heaven, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly to ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no. Ala Rasulullah, no. Can you? Ala qalbik. Directly from the heaven toward your heart. Subhanallah. لتكون من المنذرين. Subhanallah. Alif Lam Mim Sad. Kitabun, a book. Unzila ilayk, has been sent down to you. Then Fala yakun, be careful, watch out. What? فَلَا يَكُمْ فِي صَدْرِكَ. Why everything is toward this? This is the place. This is what makes one of us in such a cold weather wake up and go to Fajr prayer. It is not how much muscles do you have. It's not how clever you are. This is the victory. If you watch and pay attention to your heart, how to get it to the best, toward the excellence. Can we start our journey from the Holy Quran itself? So we know now the main purpose for our existence, the main purpose of sending the Quran to us, the main organ that we need to get to action to have the most benefit from the Holy Quran. Do you want us to have some examples of how that Quran, that Holy Quran, wakes our hearts and change our behavior? Do you know the jinn? Jinn, when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was forced to go out of Mecca, he went to Taif to give da'wah, and he was kicked out of Taif by force, in a very, very actually nasty way. Then he went and left Taif. He was not welcomed there. And he went and he stopped at Wadi Nakhla. And then he started praying. You cannot describe his emotion. Even when he said to Aisha radiallahu anha, Ummuna, in Sahih al-Bukhari, when she asked the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, what was the worst event and the worst scene in your life, in your entire life? The life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is full with events that have a major impact in the one who listens to it. What about the one who felt it at the beginning, who was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Yani, you know, when he was in his mother's womb, his father died. Then after he was delivered, with 2 years, his mother died. Then he went, whenever he loves someone, he leaves him. When he loves his mother, he went to Halima. When he loves Halima, they get him back. And his mother died. And when he loves Jaddu Abdul Muttalib, his grandfather, he died. Then when he loves, so his life was full of, you know, disasters again in the materialistic way or materialistic life. Yet he said that this is the worst scene in my life. When I was forced to leave Mecca, then I was forced to leave Taif, then I had no place to go. But something amazing happened in Wadi Nakhla. He started to pray. All humans rejected him, alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the jinn. But they did not, you know, they did not stand in, you know, rows. There was no place for them. No place for them on the earth. So they just accumulated and clustered above each other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنَّهُ لَمَّا قَامَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ يَدْعُوهُ, when he was praying, كَادُوا يَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِ لِبَدًا. The earth could not accommodate them. Just on top of each other. They were just listening to what the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says and what he was reciting. When they hear the Quran, they hear it with no. They did not feel it with any since they took it from heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Jinn, قُلْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْهِ. Tell people, tell your people, O Muhammad, tell your people, أنه استمع نفر من الجن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say سَمِعَ. There is a difference between سَمِعَ, which we do sometimes when we hear Quran, we سَمِعَ, we hear it. إِسْتَمَعَ, it's a careful, more careful form of listening. إِسْتَمَعَ نَفَرٌ مِّنَ الْجِنِّ فَقَالُوا. فَ in Arabic language means immediately. Immediately, once النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام finished the recitation, فقالوا. Who said so? Who said that until he finished? To see how well behaved they were, subhanAllah. وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِّنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْمَعُونَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. They were carefully listening to the Holy Quran. فَلَمَّا حَضَرُوهُ, when they were there, قَالُوا أَنْصِتُوا. Everybody is telling others to keep silent. Just listen. أنصتوا. When they fulfilled the two criteria, two main criteria, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنِ, what? فَاسْمَعُوا لَهُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ. Only وَأَنصِتُوا. Pay the most attention you have, the maximum attention you can. Huh? What will happen if you fulfill these two criteria? لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Did al-jinn fulfill these two criteria? يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنَ فَلَمَّا حَضُرُوا قَالُوا أَنصِتُوا. استمعوا أنصِتُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept his promise or not? To give them rahmah, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. You have only to fulfill the requirement and don't ask about the promises, because no one could keep his promise more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَمَّا حَضَرُوهُ قَالُوا أَنصِتُوا. Told each other to keep silent. فَلَمَّا قُضِي, until he finished. وَلَّوْا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِمْ مُنْدِرِينَ. What did they say? فَقَالُوا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا, that we heard something, قُرْآنًا عَجَبًا, amazing. This is their word. It is amazing. How many times did you hear or listen to the Quran and you felt in your heart, what an amazing verses are they? You just, it really shaked you from inside. How many times? Sometimes it happened, especially in Ramadan. Sometimes when you go out to the mosque, the Taraweeh, and your colleague or your friend says, did you hear, did you listen to the verse in the second rak'ah? But you were out there. He said, yeah, yeah. Because it reaches here, but it may reach here for someone. When it touches here, you will feel what I say. And this is not my statement. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's statement. So they said, فَقَالُوا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا قُرْآنًا عَجَبًا, that we have never heard such an amazing verses or an amazing talks, words. So what? You heard an amazing Quran, so what? يهدي إلى الرشد. It like your responses. It guided you to the right way. Huh? يهدي إلى الرشد. Okay, so all of us, we know that it is a guidance. But what is next? There is a difference between knowing from here and knowing from here. When you know from here, there will be something next. There will be next, not something to come. But if you know from here, it's not necessarily that you will change. صح? Lots of things that we know from our minds that it's good, but we don't know, we didn't do it. Smokers, they know that smoking is a cancerous. It's dangerous. صح? Yet, they do it. So they say, يهدي إلى الرشد. Immediately what? فآمنا به. خلاص. We believe in it. What is next? ولن نشرك بربنا أحدا. We will never associate a partner with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Because the Holy Quran is about this. About the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How come do you want me to pray to someone who is a creator from like me? So وَلَن نُشْرِكَ بِرَبِّنَا أَحَدًا وَأَنَّهُ تَعَالَى جَدُّ رَبِّنَا مَتَّخَذَ صَاحِبَةً وَلَا وَلَدَا سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ. We need to have this stance, this belief, and the action afterward. If you read the Holy Quran, you will know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test you not with what you see good to do it. No, what you see bad to do it, and what you see good, you beloved to you, and to leave it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The whole Quran about it. All the stories in the Holy Quran talks about the tawheed, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the trust that you must have in order to live the best form of life. The best form of life. Do you want us to have an example? An example? I was in the state, and I was asked, again, like this one, short notice, and the speaker did not come, so I came in. I was invited to give a talk in the mosque, and those people who are responsible, the trustees of the mosque, they asked me while we were walking to the mosque, they said, please talk about anything except Tawheed. I said, okay, mashallah, what are we talking about then? Anything about apart from Tawheed, don't talk about Tawheed. I said, wait, why? He said that most of the people there, they will give you a hard time after the lecture, and they will ask about Tawheed, lots of issues. Actually, I said I will talk about Tawheed from the Holy Quran, and I'm ready to accept anything. I will be for it. So I asked them one question at the beginning of the lecture. I asked them one question. I said, the Holy Quran and all the stories in the Holy Quran talks about Tawheed. Give me any, this is what the question I asked in the mosque, give me any surah or any story in the Holy Quran that does not talk about Tawheed, and I will leave the mosque. First announcement, nobody volunteered to suggest a story. I announced again, second time, no one volunteered. I announced third time, give me any story, otherwise I will choose, but you may say I'm biased. And then there was a guy whom they threatened me with. They said, this guy will give you a hard time. Wallahi. They said, this guy will give you a hard time. Wallahi, like if I see him now, he was sitting in the last one in the row, and he was sitting like this and just looking at me. And he said, the cave. The story of Ashab al-Kahf, the cave. I said, okay then, subhanAllah. Do I know you? He said, no. This is the first time I have ever met this guy. So there's no arrangement between us. The cave, what is the story of Ashab al-Kahf? You will realize that all the stories in the Holy Quran is about the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ. Young men, آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ. They had a strong faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدَىٰ. Then we rewarded them with for that iman, for that strong belief, with more and more guidance. What did they say? What is their issue? Why did they leave their country? Why those seven people, seven young men, they left their country? Was it because they didn't have jobs? No, they were sons of the kings in the country. So they were the most wealthy individuals at that time. So they didn't get job, or they didn't get horses, or no. So what made them decide to go out? وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدَى وَرَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ إِذْ قَامُوا فَقَالُوا. They stood up and they said, what? رَبُّنَا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Our Lord is the Lord and the owner of the heaven and the earth. So what? لَن نَدْعُوَ مِن دُونِهِ إِلَهَا. We will never associate a partner with him. This is our issue. It's not about the financial status, it's not about anything else, a social, psychological, no. It is because of the tawheed. لَن نَدْعُوَ مِن دُونِهِ إِلَهًا لَقَدْ قُلْنَا إِذًا شَطَطَ هَؤُلَاءِ قَوْمُنَا. Our people, then they mentioned the case, the situation, the problem with them, the issue, the main issue. هَؤُلَاءِ قَوْمُنَا اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ إِلَهًا آلِهَا. They invoked and they pray upon someone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مِن دُونِهِ آلِهَةً لَوْلَا يَأْتُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِسُلْطَانٍ بَيِّنٍ. They should at least bring one evidence that this Aliha has created them or fed them, has fed them. What is the next verse? فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا. They could not get or bring any evidence forward, and they are unfair, injustice to worship someone that had not created them, had not fed them, had not nothing for them. What is the next verse? وَإِذِ اعْتَزَلْتُمُوهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commenting on the scene. اعْتَزَلْتُمُوهُمْ, you left them. وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ, and whatever they were worshipping. إِلَّا اللَّهِ. It is only because of Allah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded them. فَأُوا إِلَى الْكَهْفِ. Then head to the kahf, to the cave. Subhanallah. If I ask you now, if you want to save those guys, to provide security for those seven individuals, where would you put them? Would you ever think about putting them in a cave? This is the last place you would even think about putting them there, صح? This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to see from your heart. Something appears very terrifying, but trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Trust Allah. If I ask you why, if you want to save your kid, would you put them in the kids? Would you put them in cave? No. If I ask you why, you would say first, the cave by its own is terrifying. صح? Right?